everybody. Here we are. We're going to talk about a new model. It is called the eGO, and it is a new electronic cigarette model that you have right there. If many of you have been following me, subscribing, or watching my series, you know that the 510 is the one that I really liked. I still like it. Still use it. It was one of those things that did assist me going from regular tobacco, moving over to electronic cigarette. Here you have something that's very close to a real cigarette, and it had the button, so that was enough for me to really work on, let alone going to some of these other models. And here's the eGO right here, just showing you size-wise. That's something that probably might turn off a lot of new users that you have right there. So let's look at this. The pros, obviously, here, it's very similar to cigarette. I still feel that it's very easy to move over that you have right there. And it works really well. It seems like every 5 minutes they have a new electronic cigarette coming out, and I do try them, and I test them out. The eGO, I was impressed. It was something that I didn't use for days or weeks, but literally months, and durability is up there. There's a lot of competitors now. You can buy a lot of cheap knockoffs that you have right there, and they're named everything under the sun. The eGO there, it has stood by that you have right there. Obviously, the pros with this one is it's light, it's easy to use. One of the cons is, obviously, the battery life that you have right there. One thing that you have to remember as far as the button goes, and I get this question a lot, if you're a new user, listen up here, and that is, Shawn, how long does this battery last me? Well, that really depends on how long you inhale for. If you press down on a button for 2-3 seconds and you inhale, or you're somebody else who does a really long inhale, which a lot of us smokers do, and that's why we love this model that you have right there, you're going to inhale for 5 to 7 seconds. Well, you have one person inhaling for 3 seconds, you have one person inhaling for 7, do the math, right? The person inhaling for 7, the battery's going to last less than 50% of the amount of time. So these batteries can go anywhere from 45 minutes up to a couple of hours, depending on what you have. In comes the eGO. Now, the eGO is nothing really revolutionary, everybody. It is just a 510 with a really big battery. This is a 650 mAh, milliamps per hour. That's what the mAh stands for. I'm going to take off the battery atomizer cover. All this is a fancy little thing that makes the electronic cigarette look nice. So off that comes, that you see right there, just something to make it look nice. Here I'm revealing the atomizer that's used. And guess what? Look at that. Same atomizer that you're looking. Same 510 atomizer, same cartridges, whatever you're using. That really appealed to me because, hey, guess what? I don't have to run out and buy a bunch of cartridges. I don't have to worry about all this other stuff. So it wasn't that I moved over to the eGO. It was something that I put into my electronic cigarette collection, and I really do enjoy it. It's something nice around my workshop or watching TV, whatever that might be. Going out in public more often, I still use my 510, but I do like the eGO 650 that you have right there. So that was kind of nice. Now, be forewarned, this does take a different charger. So the charging of the battery, and that's because, it's larger milliamps, so it does take a little bit more that you have right there. So they came out with the 650. And then guess what they did, everybody? Very quickly in succession, they came out with the 900 mAh, which, as we can see, is just even longer battery. Now, this is one of those that it really depends. Ladies out there, you might like the 650. It's a little bit smaller. I actually enjoy the 650 that you have right there. The 900, you're going to get a little bit more battery time out there. And we're talking a huge difference of battery time from 510 to the 650. The 900, a little bit more. And we're talking, here, you're easily looking at several hours, even if you're a hardcore smoker. So that is something that's nice. So here you have the 510. Sorry. And here you have the 650. Guess what? It came out with an 1100. This is almost even too big for me. I mean, the 900 lasts a pretty long time. I'm pretty happy with it. The 1100 is very bulky, really hard to keep into the mouth, and causes a little bit of problems as far as into the PCC and some of that thing for the eGO itself. Now, here's another one that came out. And this one rolled out pretty much right after the succession of this. And I do believe that this one here really has something that can be offered to a lot of people. For me personally, this model that I'm holding up, the eGO T, doesn't work out so well. For me personally, okay? I was a pretty heavy smoker that you have right there. And I'm one of those people that I don't mind. Many of you who start using e-cigs, you got to keep your cartridge full. You have to refill it quite often, things that you have right here. The eGO T, the T stands for tank. Okay, and that's exactly what this is up here. Now, this model that we're looking at, everybody, you do need a new atomizer. It takes a completely new atomizer. This is not just a cover. It's the actual atomizer itself that you have right there to show that it's a legitimate eGO T. It actually says it on the atomizer that you have right here. What's really big about this is this particular piece that you see, this pops out, and this is a tank. Right, so this takes a couple of milliliters of e-liquid, and it's really easy the way it works. It just, did I really need to say on the video? This works so easy to take off. Why did I cut my nails today, huh? All right, and this is brand new. There we go. All right, here it is. So the top pops off there, and you just fill this up with e-liquid right here. It's really easy, and then you have a little topper there. Put the topper on. Right, and then you put it back in and you're good to go. Now for me personally, I didn't think that my throat sensation, you know, the feeling of smoke was as powerful with this, but my wife really liked it. She took to this, you know, like a duck to water. So it was something that I really, you know, kind of paid attention to and said, okay, you know, this particular model will really help a lot of people. This is always good for a lot of people. I do get some you know, messages from long, you know, overhaul truckers, things of that nature. What's nice about this is you don't have to fiddle as much. And that's really the only time that I notice with my 510 or my regular egos that you have right there of filling them up that I have a little bit more difficulties. You've seen it in my other videos, you know, don't drip and drive. And that's one of the things where this, you don't have to worry about that. So it is something to definitely consider if you're somebody who doesn't like the fiddling of the e-cigs as far as filling them up all the time. This is something that is kind of nice. It's called the eGO T. I can see why it's a little bit of a buzz. Again, this one here, man, you know, there's just been tons of knockoffs that are coming out on that, but this is one to keep an eye out for. So that kind of hits up about the egos. Who knows, maybe my next one will be about the eGO 30,000 mAh, and it'll be about this long. But talk to you guys soon. Thank you very much, and see ya.
Prepare and leg rest, 50 cents to spare. Sometimes I dance all night, sometimes I wouldn't dare.